This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I want to show how to calculate the total number of milliliters that will be infused over a given period of time. So here's the first problem. A patient's IV is set at 30 drops per minute. The drop factor is 10 drops per milliliter. How many milliliters will the patient receive in 5 hours? Okay, so let's set up our equation this way. We'll start out with the drip rate. That's 30 drops per minute. So I'm going to have 30 GTT over minutes. Now before I put in the rest of this, let's add an equal sign. And way over on the right, let's write down the unit we want to end up with. We want to find out how many milliliters the patient's going to receive. So I'll put milliliters over here. Okay, the other information we have is that the drop factor is 10 drops per milliliter. I want to end up with milliliters in my answer. So I'm going to write this, the second fraction, as 1 milliliter over 10 drops, or 10 GTT. I'm also told that the process will take 5 hours. The infusion will take 5 hours. So I've got 5 hours, and I'll just put that over 1 to keep everything as a fraction. Since I've got minutes and hours, I want to convert the hours into minutes, so I'll use the conversion, 60 minutes over 1 hour. And now I should be able to cancel out all of the units except for the milliliters. So let's see. The minutes will cancel out, the drops, or GTT, will cancel out, the hours are going to cancel out, I've got a 10 in the denominator down here, and I've got a 30 over here in the numerator, so let's divide both of those by 10. 10 divided by 10 is just 1, 30 divided by 10 is 3, and now I've got 3 times milliliters, times 5 times 60. Well, 3 times 5 is 15, and 15 times 60 is going to be 900, and I've still got milliliters, so that's 900 milliliters. Okay, let's do one more. This one's pretty similar. If the drip rate is 25 GTT, or 25 drops per minute, and the drop factor is 50 drops per milliliter, how many milliliters will the patient receive in 24 hours? Okay, so once again, I'm going to start out with that drip rate. That's 25 GTT over minutes. I'll go over to the right here, put an equal sign in, and leave a space for the answer, and write the units I want to end up with, which will be milliliters. And let's see. I've got a drop factor that's 50 drops per milliliter. So I'm going to write that as 1 milliliter over 50 GTT, 50 drops. I've got a 24-hour time period. So that's 24 hours. I'll put that over 1 so I can keep everything as a fraction. And once again, I want to convert hours and minutes. So I'll use the fraction 60 minutes over 1 hour. Now we'll cancel out the units. GTT will cancel, the drops will cancel. The minutes are going to cancel out. The hours are going to cancel out. I'm left with milliliters. That's what I want to end up with. Now I can simplify the numbers here. I've got a 25 and a 50, so I could divide both of those by 25. The 25 will just become a 1. And the 50 divided by 25 will become a 2. And since I've got this 2 and 24, let's divide both of those. The 2 becomes a 1. 24 divided by 2 is 12. Now I've got a 1, the milliliters, and then 12 and 60. So 12 times 60 is 720, and that's going to be milliliters. 720 milliliters. Okay? So I hope this helps. Take care. I'll see you next time.